For Tegan and Sarah, I'm very happy to be home. Thanks for having us tonight. Sit down again. So
that's true.
We've been making an effort to give some direction for sitting and standing, because I think that sometimes people want to stand up and some people want to sit down. So I think for this next song, even if you don't want to stand up, you should stand up just for this one song. See how it feels. Test it out. Especially the front row should stand up.
Yoga, or like you can skip aerobics today. It's gonna be fantastic. How do you feel? You feel good? I can already feel your excitement. I feel your muscles. I feel everything being really excited. We're having a technical difficulty, which Tegan is currently working on, but this is good. I like that you're standing up. I feel like, ready? I don't seem to have, you.
No?
No. It's first half for me. 29 years later, I just really miss not having you. How many people does it take to plug in the monitor? Yes, I am. You don't really do a lot during this next song. You kind of just hang out.
I just want to chill out.
Okay.
I'll just chill out over here.
Yeah, well, you can still play. I just won't hear you. But
not a big deal.
I keep it pretty low in my monitor as it is. So.
Yeah.
Necessary for the show, so that all the people who are too tired to stand up, they won't have to feel embarrassed. I'll do it for them. I just recognize your right to sit down, but not for this one.
Yeah.
If you want to sit down, you can for a few. You can sit down if you want for a few. I mean, if you're tired.
Are you asking us or telling us?
It's been a few years since we played a proper show in Calgary, and I want to thank you guys for supporting us. It's really exciting to be able to play two shows here at the Jubilee. Thank you so much. We've been talking about it all day, but this is the place where when we graduated high school, we came here. I saw Joseph in the amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat when I was in grade 11. I think, if I exactly remember. But anyways, it's very exciting for us, and we really appreciate it, and it means a lot to us. And so thank you for already being a fantastic audience. I appreciate it. Whether you're sitting or standing, I like you. I like you a lot. And I'll dedicate this one to you now.
Really?
You, the group.
Yeah,
I
don't want to say that.
Tell me that you know I'm the way to get a tennis on me. Or how I would be, but it's a different situation. Different situation. Lay awake and I just stare at the ceiling above. Keep on trying to remember, so nothing will be lost in the end. When you burn, burn, burn your life down, get me to the door, out of bed, on the track. I'm not sure. Starting over, it's a different situation. Different situation. Wake up in the morning, refuse to be afraid of it now. Falling pieces of investor, don't you waste your time. You keep trying to remember this, and nothing will be lost in the end. Then you burn, burn, burn your life down. Then you burn, burn, burn your life down.
So, what do you do with the left of you? How do you know when it's time to let go? Where's the good go? Where's the good go? Look me in the eye and tell me you don't find me attractive. Look me in the heart and tell me that you won't go. Look me in the eye and promise no love is like I love. Look me in the heart and I'm very broken. So happily, why instead of
you'll go. Look me in the eye and promise no love as I got love. Look me in the heart and I'll be broken. I won't have things. So please it hurts to see your love always thinking you would be really happy and healthy, strong and firm. Where's the good girl? Where's the good girl? Look me in the eye and promise no love, cause I got love. Look me in the heart and I'm break broken, I won't have any soul. Please embrace the sea of love, always thinking you would be real happy and healthy, strong and firm. Where's the good girl? Where's the good girl? So please embrace the sea of love, always thinking you would be real happy and healthy, strong and calm. Where's the good girl?
Sentimental mood, I see. I think so. This next one is for all the people who are dancing. You're adorable. Last time we played here at the Jubilee a couple years ago, my grandpa was in the front and he came back and he was like, there was some girl really tall dancing in front of me the whole time. I couldn't see anything. What do you say? I mean, I don't know.
Yeah,
so today I called him and I was like, Grandpa, I was going to try to get you a balcony seat, but we only have floor seats. And I was like, I don't know if I'll be able to stop people from dancing in front of you. And he was like, what, do you think I'm old or something? I'll be fine. I was like, but remember 2 years ago? No. He's gonna have a good time.
Yeah, I think he's pretty, I mean, he's pretty badass for a grandpa, and I do think, the thing that's so funny to me is that I don't know that he's as put off by the dancing as he is by, like, his vision being blocked. Like, I think if we just had, like, a throne or something for him, that would be easier. Like, and then he could decide, like, at one concert that we played, he was standing up the whole time, he just wanted us to make sure that, you know, that he had a good spot by the soundboard and that there was candy on hand because he's diabetic and, like, it's, we're not really, there's no room in this family for our divas. What was that, Mr. Sir? I'm cute. You think I'm cute, like an elf, like a mime on Halloween that has really interesting names. Cute, like you want to marry me. Cute, like you want to marry me and then hang out with my grandpa all the time. So you like my grandpa. Okay. And we're gonna return to the music part. And anyone who wants to just stand up and just give her, don't even care if your friends are laughing at you. I'm not laughing at you. I'm laughing together with you. Enjoy.
We'll be right back. Thank you.
But the second song that I wrote was, can't remember what that one was called either. But I wrote both of them in Calgary, and whenever I'm here, I know, I can't remember either names. No, that's part of the story, don't worry. Yeah, it's all part of that story. Take a breather, sister. But I wrote them in Calgary. Whenever I'm back in Calgary, I always find that my head is flooded full of like weird memories about music when I'm playing. There's two. That's awesome. Me and that guy, we got something in common, but anyway, but one of the things I was just thinking about in this flood of memories was that Sarah and I, even back in the day when we were teenagers writing songs, we never wrote together. We always did that separately, and then we would just be like, can you run the ghetto blaster and press record for me? And then, for people who are really young and don't know what that is, it's like an iPod machine, but it's really big and it's like cassettes. That was basically Sarah's script from last night. But it was about DVD players. It's called Stealing. Probably a lot of people do it, but anyway. So we never used to play that much together. We were just out of convenience. It was like a Tegan and Sarah show. Well, it was actually a Sarah and Tegan show. It was mainly like we were just co-hosting. It was kind of like, well, do you want to play a show with me? And Sarah would be like, I guess. So we would play the show together, but as time has passed and we've evolved, we have actually learned how to cooperate and to share the burden. And so this next song that we're going to play is the first official Tegan and Sarah song that we wrote together. So, even if at the end you're like, I like Back in Your Head better, you should still really cheer loud because what you want if you like Tegan and Sarah first is keep being Tegan and Sarah, not being, you know what I mean? This could cement our future together. If we write a song that people freak out about, we'll go off stage and I'll be like, oh my god, people love Paper Back Head. They love that song. You can never leave me. I'm the glue that holds your money in your wallet. Tell the weird story right before I have to do something that I feel uncomfortable with. Like play sideways on the keyboard. And then like I feel like
you're turning the keyboard around, face them.
No. This is the song where I channel my this is where I channel Tiffany. No. Yes. If you call my name, I'll answer, but if you call Tegan's, I'll tell you to be quiet. I swear to God, we'll pick up some momentum again here in a second, but the guy that keeps yelling your name, are you the same guy that I was talking to before? The one that thinks I'm cute? Now he's quiet, because probably his friends like, put a jacket over his face and are sneaking around. Okay. If you keep calling my name, I'm going to publicly talk to you in front of everyone and eventually embarrass you. So do it again. And you know your fate. Some people are into that. It's like it's sort of like being into BDSM or something. But if you want it rough, you can keep talking to me and I'll keep talking back at you. It's just that I sort of want to know what your name is and where you work. And
there he is.
There he is. Are you hurt? Like, did you fall in a well? Or are you just like, yeah. I'm gonna call him Mike. Okay, let's play this song. This game is for. Okay, this looks fun.
Just fine.
a material girl.
Asking me how to
the feeling that you get when you meet somebody and you think that they might be the one that you're gonna date next. A lot of people I know have been getting engaged or have been saying things like, this is the person I'm gonna spend my whole life with. A lot of people have been saying that to me lately, and it could be because all my parents got, like, married and divorced, even if they didn't actually get married, like, so many times, that our model is that you shouldn't spend your life with the same person, because then you get really bored. Maybe not bored, but I've always thought that you should just be happy, and if you're not happy, then it's okay to move on, you know, to something else. But I still like it when people around me say when they met somebody like 2 months later, when they're like, this is the person I'm gonna spend my whole life with. Because that's funny to me. Mainly because it's not really at 2 months that they start to leave all the condiments out on the counter after they make a sandwich or It's not until they move in that they start mixing your laundry in with theirs, and then all your stuff gets dry, even though it's supposed to be hung up to dry. It's not until like probably 2 or 3 years that your bed, even though it's a queen size, feels like a single. But I still find it so romantic. I mean, I'm not a therapist, but it sounds like to me perhaps you just shouldn't live with the person that you're dating, and that would help, be helpful for you.
Well, I don't live with the person that I'm dating
before. Yeah, it's not, I'm not actually talking about me, I'm trying to relate to people right now. I'm trying to tie it into the song here.
It's so funny that you thought to tell a really, like a universal theme story. I was going to talk about how long we were, about around this age that you would go.
Okay, so I'm gonna pause my story.
Go yeah, pause your story. I would have just told the story about drinking like purple coolers at Prairie Winds and barfing.
Yeah! Well, if I had ever done that, I would have told that story, but since it was only you that did that, I'm not telling that story. So, pause.
Yeah, pause.
No. My story's, I'm pausing now. Yeah.
My story's so much more fun, though.
It is, and guess what? You have like 400 other songs you can tell it in front of.
Yeah.
You know what song you could tie it into? Is Back in Your Head.
Yeah.
Now, where were we? Oh, yeah.
Why were you insulting the institution of marriage?
Right. Insulting the institution of marriage. I mean, everyone can get married. Pandas, people who've known each other 5 minutes, third cousins, people who are only wanting to get into the country and get free healthcare. And because we live in the great country of Canada, gay people. Which is something I'm very proud of. Yeah. I just want to, like, marry, like, 1,000 girls and then divorce them just to do it. just to take advantage of all my friends in America who can't do it. I just want to do it. I just want to get married and travel around being like, oh yeah, I got married and divorced last week. It was cool. Anyway, I got off track there, but this next song really is about how, when you meet somebody, how you think that you could be with them forever, but I read this book once that said that feeling is actually your instinct's way of telling you to run away. That we've confused evolution over time, we've confused that feeling of anxiety and nervousness and fear as a good thing, because it's actually our instinct's way of telling us that that's not a suitable partner for us. But I think that's kind of romantic too. I felt you in my legs before I even met you. And when I lay beside you for the first time, I told you I feel you. How's everybody on the balconies doing? You were all the way back there, and it occurred to me that maybe I should spend more time with you. Good God, that balcony, out of control. They're unleashed. Carefully, you'll detach and fall on the people below you. I love it. You guys are out of control. You're having a party up there. You're like a party boost. You guys are really having a good time. Do you all know each other? Is that where my friend Mike is sitting? Yeah. Look at someone's dancing in my shirt. It's terrifying. You're really living it in the red shirt. There's not even any music playing. Do you have your iPod on? You guys are great. We've got a couple more songs for you. This next song is officially the first song we've ever had played on the radio in Canada. So. Which this is totally fair. Tonight's show is being taped by CBC Radio 2, which is very exciting. CBC's always supported us. I mean that other kind of radio where they don't play together a lot. But anyway, I can hear this on the radio all of a sudden, which is really exciting. That I start thinking that I'm someone else, but okay. Okay, here we go. I'm not afraid of the dark.
say handsome too. I usually say the talented and handsome Ted Downs. Sorry, Ted. Maybe a redo. Could everyone in here please give a welcome to my friend, the talented and handsome Mr. Ted Downs on keyboard and bass. Thanks for being here, Ted. I'm sorry, Ted. Someone's interrupting your introduction. Hold on.
Sing me happy birthday.
Sing me happy birthday. Birthday to you. Person who doesn't sing, please. Sing my happy
birthday.
What's your birthday? What birthday number is it? 21.
Happy birthday, Mr. and Mrs. Definitely. You're not a Mr. and a Mr. Sometimes people think I'm a mistake too. But anyways, happy birthday. What's your first name? What is it?
Jessa.
I'm sorry. I'm definitely missing. Happy birthday to Jessa. And now everybody knows that you are the person at the front of the room who was confident or fast. Alright, well, and I'm sure that Ted doesn't mind. He doesn't mind that we had this little pause in his introduction. If you don't mind, is it okay if we go back to Ted now? Is that okay? Okay. I hope you have a great birthday.
Happy birthday to Ted. Happy birthday to Ted, the handsome friend of Tegan Gallows. Happy birthday to Ted.
I don't know how you feel like I had that introduction if you wish you a happy birthday too. Okay. I wasn't sure if you were taking over.
No.
Okay. Next, it's not his birthday.
No, it's not.
But he is also talented and handsome. He plays a very loud instrument. You may have heard of him tonight. You may have seen him. You may have thought, who is that young, talented, handsome man up there? That is Johnny Andrews on the drums, everyone. I couldn't really hear you tonight, but I think that you probably did a fantastic job. There was no point where I felt like we weren't on the beat. You led us very well.
Does this altitude make you feel like you need an oxygen machine after the show?
A little bit.
You drink a lot of water? Me and you tonight.
I haven't drank any of my lips, so it can fall off.
Me and Johnny are going to be on the oxygen machine tonight. That's what I'm
doing. Last but certainly not least, you sure you don't want to introduce him? No?
Maybe I should.
You seem like you really want to introduce them. Get in there. I know you're oxygen deprived. Get in there. You'll probably come up with something clever. Get in there. Do it.
I just feel excited tonight.
That's yeah, awesome. To be excited. Be excited all over the song.
Awesome!
Get in there. Song's dying for your intro.
He's the last person every single night, and Tegan always runs out of steam before she gets to him. But I think that
excuse me, my introduction last night for Sean got him in the paper.
It's true. He's now an international superstar known as Tegan's best friend. Your mom was so proud, right? She emailed you today and said, she called
she
you.
She saw it on Google.
Sean Huberts, bass player and Tegan's best friend.
That was special. That was really special. We're gonna play a couple more songs for you, but I want to dedicate this next song to our good friends in Ann Horse, who started us off this evening. Let's give them a huge round. Their record, Rearranged Beds, is one of our favorite records of the year. If you haven't checked it out yet, you should. They're gonna be out at the merch table, and they're selling the record. Tomorrow they're playing at Megatunes. They're from Australia.
They're my best friend.
They're Sarah's best friend, but they also speak incredibly funny English. You should just go talk to them for a minute. Especially if you're feeling sad. Like if this show made you feel sad. Whoa, they're dark. Go talk to Kate and Damon. They're really dark too, but you can't even tell because of the funny little accent. They're like, anyway, this one's for Emma. Thanks for being here tonight. We'll be right back. face in your eyes. I got more. You stand back and wait like an animal on a pharmacy. And I do not know what it means to be. This is your last chance, my friend. All the windows are standing. Take me in. Be tired. I want to live your life. I have money and I'm
we'll be right back.
I know I already said it, but really, thank you so much. You guys have been really terrific and so supportive to us in Calgary. We really, really appreciate it. Thank you so much. I don't know how many shows we've played in Calgary in 11 years, or whatever, 14 or 15 years, if you count, like, the party we played at Jay's house in 1997, but a lot of people have been supporting us for a really long time, and not just our friends and family who have to support us, but, because we forced them, but also strangers, and we really, really appreciate it, and we get really excited to come back to Calgary and play. Quite nervous, but you guys have really been terrific. So we're gonna play a couple of songs, just two minutes. For some reason, it feels particularly like sentimental to do that because we did a lot of acoustic shows in Calgary, and truly in Canada. When we were growing up and when we were first starting to build our career. The high school, there was a lot of like coffee shop gigs and shows and like sports bars and that sort of thing, which is really true of us. And so anyways, imagine now that we're in a coffee shop or in a sports bar, and behind us is maybe perhaps a World Series or something like that. Or don't imagine. Between us and the bed. Repeat, repeat the words that I know you both said. Relax into the me, we get so comfortable. Remember when I was so strange and laughable.
So we can, not no touring, just
just a little less to it. But anyways, hotel that I was staying at has a couple bars in it, and I came downstairs and I was sitting waiting for a friend to pick me up, and when I was coming out to sit down, I almost got run over by this really expensive sports car. Like, it's like this bar, like a lot of like really famous people come and hang out at it, and I'm not one of them. And as I was nearly killed by this car and kind of jumped out of the way and sat down on my couch, I looked over to see who it was, and it was Lindsay Lohan and Samantha Ronson. Which I thought was, I don't even know what the word is for that, but I mean, if you look at that, I hope it's like Paul McCartney or something.
Yeah, exactly.
Or Mike Tyson, who I saw that time, which was pretty fun. Anyway, so there I am, I'm sitting on this couch, and there's Lindsay Lohan and Samantha Ronson, and I had this thought in my head, you know, about touring and the road and how strange it is, and I got this idea that we should make a book, and that we should document our lives in a different way than we had before. You know, we've documented it with songs, and we've documented it with movies, and we documented online, but I thought, a book. You know, people don't have hard CDs as much anymore. We don't have that tangible item in our hands. You know, when we were kids, when the new Smashing Pumpkins record would come out, we would anticipate it. We would anticipate it in a way that I don't think people anticipate anything anymore, because it's like, oh, this band has a new record, oh, wait. So it's, the anticipation is gone, and I thought that what's really hard to leak a book is what assholes will sit at home and scan three single pages. So we started this year and a half long journey making this book, and it ended up becoming three books. And we got all sorts of artists and friends of ours who were in bands to write stuff, even Ann Horse, who's up tonight, they wrote stuff for the book too. And there's the cute little faces are in the book too. But anyway, the books are for sale tonight, and you know, no way I have to go rush out and get them, but they're pretty awesome, and they're much cheaper here than if you buy them online. And if you want to scan all 300 pages onto the internet, could you please send it to us? Because I'd love an online version, but I'm too lazy to do it. Anyway, but the books turned out really good. And you know, someone was saying to me the other day that it made them feel like they finally understood after knowing us for so long why we do what we do. And that made me really happy, because it's hard to explain to people why we leave and why we go on the road and you know, have sacrificed kind of having normal lives in a lot of ways, because it's hard for people to feel this, because you know, nobody really gets to be up here and feel this and sing the songs. And I was really excited that the book made them understand some part of what you guys give us, because the books are really about our relationship with our fans and about our relationship with each other. And anyway, so I just wanted to say thanks to all of you for being here tonight. We have a lot of family and friends in the audience tonight, and I hope that at least at some point during the set that they got to themselves like, oh, good, they did it, they got through, that's all. Oh, good, their lives were not for nothing. I'm just kidding. I don't know. They got a song with the music. I don't know. I have to say something. Anyway. All right, here we go. Me.
make myself feel bad. There's a chance I'll start to do this.
Thank you, T.U. Sarah.
Sorry.